PDP, all to the people, His Excellency the National Chairman of our Green Party, Kesuchi Secondus, the National Secretary, Senator Umar Sari, the Deputy National Chairman, Senator Nazi. We are here this afternoon to inaugurate a very important committee at a very critical time in the life of our nation. The committee is the electoral and Constitutional Review Reform Committee of the People's Democratic Party, chaired by former Deputy President of the Senate, one of the best hands that had participated in the amendment of the 1999 Constitution as amended, as well as the Electoral Act 2010. Is also to chair our Reforms Committee. Other member of the Reform Committee is the Secretary of the Committee, who is also here present with us, is Barrister Sande Muturaki, SAN. We also have sitting here the former leader of the House of Representatives, Right Honorable Mulika Adeo Lai. Is it not one? Oh! The former Minister of Russia, Amala. And the caucus leader of the House of Representatives, who is also a member of the committee, Honorable Jinda. We also have with us here the member of the committee who is representing me in the House of Representatives and representing all the good people of Kabamune Ijumu, Honorable TJ Yusuf.
On behalf of the leadership of our party, this committee is key, not only key to the party or the committee, is a key to moving Nigeria forward. because anything that has to do with civilization, if it is not properly arranged and the laws are not in place, what we expect will be chaos and crisis. That's why it's important that the man who is heading this committee, well experienced, has institutional memory in terms of amendments of the constitution and electoral laws. He was also responsible at the loss of the election of 2015. He was in charge in coming out of the post-mortem examination of what happened in 2015. He headed that committee and he discharged his duties very well. That enabled the party to come out with a roadmap for the 2019 election. So it's an embodiment of experience, intellectual, and we know that the entire country, not only the party, is expected that this committee will direct, will come with everything that will be required by law in the electoral law that will give Nigerians confidence to be able to vote and their votes are counted. All necessary laws to back up the election. It is an important committee. Without this committee and without the amendments of the electoral laws, as it starts to be, we don't know where we are going in this country. Because elections cannot be conducted at the wills and caprices of some individuals in the country and the other party. It must be defined by laws, including the participation of the security agencies. It must be defined so that everyone will know their role. As citizens of the country, our role will be on that day of election, you wake up in the morning and you go to your police station and you will be able, in the simplest process, you will be able to cast your vote and your vote must be counted. And so, Your Excellency, it is this committee that will give hope to Nigerians. Because also, the luck we have is that you are also in the Senate. And we have our members also in the House of Representatives. So we charge you today as you sit with your members to formulate the amendments and necessary process that will be in these electoral laws. We also know that you will also participate in the debates to make sure that Nigerians have the best, not only for our party, but Nigerians have the best electoral laws in Africa. That of the truth, we can see democracy in Nigeria being developed to the highest level that will give our people confidence. Your Excellency, the party has deemed it necessary that we have the best in our party in the country today. The chairman of this committee is a lawyer, he has PhD in law, he's a professor. We also have lawyers, SAN, as your secretary. We have Honorable Chinda is a lawyer. We have lawyers, we have the man representing the governor's board here, very experienced in the parliamentary, the House of Rep before. And we know that these are best materials, not only in our party, but in Nigeria. And so we move forward. And as the country will look forward, the party will also look forward. That you will come out with the best when you see and you begin to craft and when you submit and also propose them at the Senate and the House of Representatives. We believe that the leadership of National Assembly must represent the constituencies, represent their constituencies. It is important that at the National Assembly, it is not always looking at the political parties, but you are representing Nigerians, the collective will of Nigerians. It is important that we do a call on the leadership of the National Assembly to do the right thing so that there will be peace in this country. Because if all our electoral laws are well in place and being guided and we obey them, there will be peace, there will be no infighting, there will be no covering during the election and after election. But one important thing I want to also touch is on the area of security. I believe that we have been overwhelmed in this country on the security issue. Look at what is happening in Nigeria. Look at what happened in Kasima. I call for this, my president, you must wake up and attend to the Nigerians. People are being kidnapped, people are being killed on a daily basis. Without security, protection of life and property, we can't even talk about election in 2020. Therefore, we call on the federal government to declare the state of emergency on security. So that when this country can hold on the form. The Excellency of that group, and on behalf of the leadership of our party, will inaugurate this important, all important committee, our electoral reform committee of the PDP. And congratulations to all of you. The executive of reference will be handed over to you by the secretary before you will respond. So just 1 second.
Public engagement at the very to demonstrate how this is important. people of this country. And I believe that this was the fact of my dead brother. When I come from this, I would like to seek your permission that we could rise for 1 minute to pray our respect to him, because it was too late from PDP member.
The soul of the Matthias Reclamation of the Rest of the Peace. Chairman, many dear colleagues, on behalf of the members of the People's Democratic Party Committee on Electoral Reform and the Constitutional Amendment, I want to thank the leadership of our great party for the confidence it puts in us to undertake this task to help deepen our democracy, build our electoral systems, and strengthen the 1999 Constitution in order to build a more fair, stable, prosperous, and better governed nation. It is also our belief that this undertaking by our great party will help the system to benefit from PDP's experience. Other leaders, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, by the way, we are pressing for a better electoral system and a more people-oriented constitution. The PDP is aligning with the gains of the overwhelming majority of Nigerians. Importantly, we are only asking all progressive governors led administration to add some critical blocks to what we have built. I can confidently say that we have done quite a lot in this regard, and that APC is the greatest beneficiary. We cannot be forgotten in a hurry that the constitutional and electoral reforms, as well as the conducive democratic climate provided by the PDP, were the springboards of APC victory in 2015, and for which we have no regrets. Chairman, as the former chairman of the Senate Committee on Constitutional Review, who was privileged to co-pilot the reforms, I can boldly state that it's a fact of history that successive PDP federal government, starting from the President Umaru-Yar'Adua administration, initiated processes that eventually presented the constitutional and electoral reforms we enjoy today. They include the financial and legislative autonomy for the independent National Electoral Commission, IMEC, including a provision that INEC's quotes, powers to take its own rules, or that was regulated from procedures, shall not be subject to the approval of the President, unquote. The elimination of membership from the political party as a qualification of appointment to INEC, time limits for the filing, hearing and termination of election petition, broader time frames for the conduct of elections, deletion of the disqualification of persons indicted by an administrative panel from standing for election due to individual abuse. Others include, Mr. Chairman, financial autonomy for the National Assembly to strengthen the principle of checks and balances, mandatory transmission of the data by the President or Governor of the National Assembly or State Assembly to enable the Vice President or Deputy Governor to act whenever they are to proceed on permission or unable to discharge their functions, during which the Deputy automatically assumes office in acting capacity after 31 days. Also, consideration. Consolidation of the independent term of office of a president or governor who won a secondary run of the election to include the period for his term in office. Mr. Chairman, you only completed some critical amendments that were at least enforced in the House of Assembly, but unfortunately denied assent by the presidency. This includes the motion of railway, aviation, power, stamp duty, among others. From the exclusive list to the concurrent list, the separation of the Office of Attorney General of the Federation of States from the Office of the Minister of Commissioner for Justice, making rights to basic education and primary health care, fundamental and justiciable rights, independent candidature, inclusion of electoral offenses as grounds to disqualify candidates from the elections, mandatory presentation of daily state of the national address, the joint session of the National Assembly by the President has made in progressive front. Strengthening the process for state creation to make them less robust. The move of the presidential assent to concerning amendment bills as is done in America. Financial autonomy for office of the general of the federation. Compulsory transmission of assets for a bill by the president or governor to the parliament in 30 days. then we can deal with the consular automatically, as is done in the United States of America, where the president has 10 days to send a vehicle. Sanction for disobeying the state of Thomas, but then the presentation of weather estimates by the president or governor later September and passed on the same later September that the president of each year. That brings for submission of duties for proposed ministers and commissioners along with their portfolios, compulsory savings of a defined percentage by the meeting, etc. All these novel positions were denied access, hence we have where we have today. Mr. Chairman, distinguished colleagues, of course, a reform of the local government system, including financial autonomy and uniform term for local government, through several, those several in the past, by National Assembly, but never approved by the assemblies. While proposed amendments like the decentralized policy and single term of 5 or 6 years for the president and governors, which have consistently championed, has constantly frustrated. My dear colleagues, President Muhammad Buhari commended the signs of electoral reforms and constitutional amendments, such as the timeframe for filing, adjudication and disposal of pre-election matters, reduction of age qualification for political office, not children to run bill, extension from 7 to 21 days, the period to take the annex shall conduct federal elections, between the two leading presidential or electoral candidates, expansion of the conditions for deregulation, for the deregulation of political parties in order to check the deregulation of parties, limited to 1 term and no more, the legitimacy of a president or governor to complete the term of an elected president or governor. And of course, amendments granting financial autonomy to state legislature and the judiciary are of the most amendments to be completed in the assembly. However, the president was simply turned down the Electoral Act Amendment in 2018 that should have enabled a more elaborate use of technologies to make our elections freer, fairer, more transparent, and more credible. By that single action, the administration squandered an important opportunity to take our electoral system to the next level and rise in those standards of electoral forces. My dear colleagues, today, the National Assembly is on the march again, and the administration has an opportunity to redeem itself. The Joint National Assembly Committee on INEC and the Joint Technical Committee on Electoral Act, which comprise the INEC, select members of the National Assembly and the civil society organizations, both of which are made member, are agreed that any primaries and electronic transmission of results from the polling units are the two most pressing reforms needed in the electoral system. As earlier stated, have there been issues of seemingly interminable election-related implications in previous electoral and personal reforms, but setting down frames for dealing with both pre-election and post-election litigation. However, INEC is still faced with challenges of short time frames to conduct the elections. The election monitoring body still works under acute pressure in preparing and managing our elections. They still get court orders and counter orders even for the need of elections as politicians struggle for their party tickets. Therefore, the Joint National Assembly Committee on INEC have agreed to recommend our colleagues and amend them along INEC to call for nomination at least 360 days to the election, and submission of list of candidates by political parties not greater than 6 months to the election, including 60 days. It means, therefore, that if passed by the National Assembly and signed by Mr. President, INEC will call for nominations for the 2023 general election by February 2022, while the political parties will have up to July 2022 to conclude their primaries and submit their list of the candidates to the INEC. That way, INEC will have ample time to prepare for elections and avoid individual reasons, while political parties will also have sufficient time to deal with issues and litigations arising from party primaries. It is important to note that this has helped both emerging democracies such as Ghana and the Republic, and the both democracies such as United States to improve the quality of the election. In Ghana, for instance, the primaries for candidates take place between a year and a year 6 months. The party in power normally goes primaries a year to the presidential election, while the party in opposition conducts primaries elections a year and 6 months before the presidential election.
So in making the proposition, we are worried for the third services. It must also be pointed out that in Ghana, for instance, it is the election management body that actually conducts the primaries for the political parties, thereby ensuring clarity and transparency. My party leader, distinguished representative, ahead of the 2015 election, the amended section 52 of the Electoral Act that allow hybrid option for using electronic voting is so there. But it has become imperative to further entrench the use of technology in our elections by not only providing for electronic voting among several others, but also by providing for the compulsory transmission of results from the polling units. This is imperative since the worrisome matching that happens between the polling units and collection centers remains a great drawback for electoral system. This manipulation of figures and falsification of results is the single most corrosive problem that erodes the confidence of the electorates in their votes capture, and is equally largely responsible for the body of violence that we dealt with our elections. But if you transmit these results electronically and directly from polling units and also upload them to the exercise at the core, the electorates and the candidates will be able to monitor the votes from anywhere and see that their votes count transparently. Therefore, I join our great party, the media, the civil society organization, and all members of democracy to rally support for these reforms, and also feel free to send in their suggestions to our committee to make our electoral system more credible and transparent. Meanwhile, the weaknesses in our structure and the constitution we operate have never been as pronounced as they are today. I must also add that it is unfortunate that the rain, which some of us sharpened on top of our voices for warning the nation against, and even proposed policies and sponsored bills that part, is now beating us heavily. Some of us were warned that PDP nationalism will only continue to increase our appetite for wealth sharing and blossoming, kill our propensity to create wealth, make us poor. It is regrettable to say that the chicken has come home to roost. Today, various levels of government, even going to pay salaries and services, and service incurring expenditures. In the absence of state police, security of lives and property has practically collapsed. I rallied my colleagues and together we sponsored a bill for the creation of state police in the International Assembly. I made sponsored a bill for the creation of state police in the current Senate. Unfortunately, we did not appear ready yet, but see the recent emergency to stem the tide of insecurity or rebuild our economy through the decentralization or devolution of powers. With the right political will, the amendments to the Constitution that achieve a decentralized police and secure lives and properties can be achieved in 10 days. So we can suspend our rules, meet Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, pass the bill for the decentralization of the police, send them to National Police Assemblies for their concurrence, return them and pass the National Police the following week, and increase access to it, and then we must start operationalizing it. Therefore, I would like to call our party members, the media, civil society, and well-being Nigerians to put narrow political, partisan, ethnic, religious, and sexual interests aside and seek the opportunity of ongoing constitutional amendments exercise to really pull our nation back from the brains. So long as we run a dysfunctional centralized policy, for that long, we are always able to reduce pains and losses continue to rise. The community policy initiative is only illusory. It is cosmetic, it is ephemeral, it is inorganic, and will certainly not change anything. Furthermore, so long as we encourage the importance of federalism and refuse to devote powers to unlock the capacities of the federal units to create wealth and build critical infrastructure, for that long, shall our borrowing and poverty continue to flourish and rule over us. It is either we do the right things to get the right results, or continue to do wrong things and live with consequences of our choices, as is presently the case. We must also have it at the back of our minds that things will govern the problem get worse. As I conclude, Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, let me thank our great party, our leaders, once again, for finding us worthy to serve on this solid program committee. Let me also reassure you and all our leaders, on behalf of my distinguished colleagues on this committee, that we are ready and indeed committed to working with Mr. President, the National Assembly, the State Assemblies, the other political parties, the National Governance Forum, all critical stakeholders and operators to substantially improve the quality of our elections through the far-reaching constitutional and electoral reforms that will pull our nation from the brinks of the economic efforts. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Another round of applause for the professor. Excellency, the National Chairman of our great party, Your Excellency, the National Secretary, and our highly esteemed members of the NWC, Your Excellency, the Chairman of this committee, and other members of the committee, I would like to, at this point, thank you, Mr. Senator, for a lucid and elaborate explanation and briefing. Both members of the National Working Committee and indeed Nigerians need to come together and work so that we can be able to have a very strong this country. It is the only way forward for this country. We have made mistakes in the past, and the chairman of this committee has explained the consequences of the mistake that were made in the past. We are desirous and we are hopeful that this time around, by the grace of God, the National Assembly will do the right thing, the needful, by ensuring that our electoral laws are passed, and we believe, just like the chairman has rightly pointed out, that the committee is willing to work for the president of this country, with good Nigerians, for the National Assembly, with all the views of ensuring that good electoral laws are passed for this country. It is on this note that we would like to, on behalf of the National Chairman of our great party,